welcome to Heartfully Creating. I just want to talk about something new. I have been acquiring a few fountain pens lately, and they're a lot different than the ones I remember when I was a teenager. So this is actually part one. I'll be sharing more details about some other pens. So I hope you're inspired to try it, or maybe learn something, or just kill some time.
Okay. Recently, if you've been following, I've been inspired by watching a channel called Peter Draws. That's D-R-A-W-S. I strongly suggest checking him out because he's hilarious as well as very creative. He's an artist, and his thing, I guess not all the time, is one of his media is fountain pens. So I haven't worked on any kind of fountain pen since I was younger, when I took a calligraphy class with my dear grandma, who went to heaven like, 19. I'm 54, so when I was about 18, which is a while ago. And it was really fun. And the pens I used back then were refillable. Like, just not refillable. They had cartridges. So you would put a cartridge inside, and then you'd have to get a new cartridge all the time, which was a real pain. So I really enjoyed the calligraphy part, but it faded out and I stopped using them. And I never bothered drawing with dip pens, with the sharp tipped pens, because I found them too scratchy. Well, thanks to Peter and his inspiration, I have discovered fountain pens, and that they're pretty affordable and they're refillable. And you have to watch for that though. And here's one I bought. It's actually a set of four, and it was only $18.99 for this set of four. And I love that they're translucent, so you can see inside. So this one has something called, and again, I give all credit to Peter Draws, about something called a piston. It has a piston inside to suck up ink. This is from a very inexpensive set, and I confess, I already opened up one to try it first, and it works really well. This has no ink in it, as of now, but this is a fountain pen, and this is a piston fill pen. So you turn it, and you see that little thing moving down, kind of like when you go get your blood drawn at the doctor's, which I don't like. So you push it down, and how it draws up the ink. So I bought some Pelican ink, some black ink here, see? Because I think it's archival, which means if I do some artwork, you don't want it to fade. And I'm trying to do this with one hand, so sorry. So I'm just going to remove this lid. And yes, I should have gloves. I should know better than this, because I could very well end up with ink all over. So I'm going to try to do this with the camera right here. I kind of do need my other hand. So I'm going to put this in here. And I don't know how to do this. Okay, let me try if I can maybe twist this with one hand, actually. So let me just try. So you just turn, you put it in the ink, and you start to twist. And I am twisting with one hand, and I might not be in ink. Oh, there it goes. So do you see how it's filling up? Sorry, it's so close. I'm just trying to do this with one hand and hold the camera because my silly tripod keeps collapsing. So there we go. Okay, I'm going to leave that in there and tip this camera up a bit so you can see. So see, it came out. It's full of ink. But like Peter says, it's all about being messy. So I'm going to lay this down here. Put this cover back on the Pelican ink, which I got for about $20 on Amazon, so pretty affordable. So Pelican, as long as it's not India ink. India ink and some of the inks that are waterproof will clog your fountain pen. Now, the thing that I thought that was great about this is, like I said, it's refillable. So it's refillable, and you can use it, and it writes really easily. And right now it's blobby at first. I noticed that with the other one. So just don't worry. You have a blotter, as my husband reminded me back in the days. My husband actually used to use, I'm just going to wipe off some of it on here. he used to use an actual dip pen. And they had a blotter, so they would blot the excess ink. Now, I've tried dip pens back in art class years and years ago, and like I said, I found the tips very scratchy and horrible to draw with. But as I watched Peter do his doodles, which are actually artwork, but he humbly calls them doodles, but they are definitely great pieces of abstract-y art and sometimes objective art. So here, so yeah, so just see. So this, so anybody who wants to begin, I highly recommend getting this set. I will blog about it and put it in the Heartfully Creating blog and put the link to the Amazon.ca link. I don't get any credit or anything for it, but yeah, it's just for anybody who wants to try. And I really like, because you can see the color of the ink that you have in there. And because it's this piston-filled one, you can refill it when it's empty or get rid of it if you wanted to change the color. And I believe this is a fine tip, so fine tip. Oh, I loved taking calligraphy with my grandma. You got to learn how to write. Now, this is what Peter says. He talks about pen tips having flex. This doesn't really have flex. Flex means, and I don't want to steal all the work that he's done, but flex means, and I'm outside, so there's a strong shadow because it's so nice out. But pushing down, you would have thick and thin lines. This particular, and these were only 1890 something for 4 pens, so you wouldn't expect a lot of flexibility or anything really great about it. And see this, yeah, might wear gloves if you want. But it's good for writing. Just ignore, I'm trying to look through the camera and write. That is a very strange experience to look through the camera and write, because I know I can write way better than that. And contrary to what's going on nowadays, I did grow up in the age of learning cursive. And this paper I'm using is just some heavyweight, large printer paper. So it has a nice smooth finish, but nothing too fancy. But I'm just drawing my name. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Let me just get a clean view right here. So drawing. So you can do lots of squiggle, squiggle. And you're not getting any missing, really. And some pens are different if you hold them straight up. I find you get some good action going side to side. I haven't done any drawing yet with this, but I am looking forward to trying, because right now I've been working on my paint pen creations. But I just thought it would be fun to try. Thank you, Peter, for inspiring me to try some fountain pens that are reusable. I did get a pretty blue ink as well, and a Dryden brand pen, and I'm waiting for a Noodler's pen, so then I will be doing my review on it. So yeah, here. So this is just dabbling in the fountain pen world. If anybody is interested in trying, it's a fairly inexpensive thing that you can try and get started on. Drawing, script, writing, cursive, calligraphy. Now, I haven't really looked into the wider tips, because when I did calligraphy, you definitely have a calligraphy set with wider tips, and there's something that you can get if you don't want to get the cartridges, like why I kind of stopped doing all that way back, because it was a pain to have to worry about getting ink cartridges. You can get if it doesn't have a piston like this to refill, there's some pens that will refill with just a eyedropper, and then there are some where you get a converter, it's called. And some pens will come with a converter, and some of them are separate, and they can actually, that's when I notice it gets a little more costly. But fountain pens have a huge range. You can get like pens for $10, fountain pens, all the way up to like, oh man, I think I saw on one of Peter's, what are those called? Like not a trade show, but something like that for fountain pens. And I saw one, I think it was $8,000. I assume it was like some kind of antique one made out of gold and had some kind of amazing treasure, or maybe some famous person used to own it. I don't know, but it was crazy. So I'm not into it like that. I'm just bringing up an old thing that I used to like, which was using fountain pens for calligraphy, but I don't plan on doing calligraphy. I plan on doing more drawing. So I'm just doodling here. But with calligraphy, you do need flex because it's all about thick and thin lines. So this one, I wouldn't recommend for that. Just drawing, just writing. I know everybody uses computers, but sometimes it's fun to actually go back to old-fashioned writing. And you just really like the smooth flowiness, you know? Yeah, if you blot it, you might get a blob of ink. But it's actually been pretty good for a very cheap pen for four in the set for $14. I'm pretty impressed. So there you go. So that with my Pelican. I will post the links in the Heartfully Creating blog. So you get 62.5 milliliters, brilliant something, brilliant black. And it said something about this being really old formula that was used and I guess has no acid or something. Whatever it is that deteriorates, that it will last. So there you go. And you'll see the other kind in the future that I got. Now, I have a question. Does anybody know why these are called fountain pens in the first place? I just realized that I don't know. And does it look like a fountain? No. However, I guess if you squirted your ink out somehow, out the tip, it might look like a fountain. And considering... Oh wow, the wind is coming up, so I'm sorry for any shakiness. It is beautiful out though. We've been having heat warnings and stuff like that, which when I ask our dear Echo Dot Alexa what is a heat warning, she says it's got to be at least 2 days at what I in Canada call 40 degrees Celsius. So we haven't been getting it that hot. Mind you, our thermometer on our window did say about 43 yesterday, but that was directly with the sun beating down. So the average was probably at more like 35, which is, yeah, that's warm enough for me. I don't know. We have a nice, lovely lady from Nigeria, and she said that there's places in Africa where the normal is 52 Celsius, which I'm thinking instant death, frankly. Couldn't do it. So anyway, so this is our fountain pen video to an introduction, and sorry, this pen is actually, because I'm drawing at a really strange angle, trying to film this and not be in the way with the shadow from the sun, I'm actually pushing in too hard to this actually really good quality paper, and it's bleeding, and the tip is actually picking up fibers of the paper, which then of course totally messes up your line. So not something you want to do. You don't want to be pressing hard with a fountain pen, but I'm just trying to doodle a little bit with some lettering, not true calligraphy, because I'm filling in all the lines and you can see how bleedy it is. It's very bleedy, lots of bleeding. You don't want bleeding, but it is what it is. So there you go. All right. Anybody want to explain to me what fountain pens are, why they're called fountain pens? That would be great. So remember to check in at the heartfullycreating.blogspot.com blog creativity, blah, blah, blah. If you have any, if you want to know of any links or see any detailed information. Thanks.